Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Bobby Okereke. And the Giants are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line.
So rare to see any quarterback toss back-to-back interceptions in the NFL, regardless of status or experience. Whether it's him personally or just the offensive game plan, I think this defense is reading something out there, and they're holding the upper hand.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. Jones throwing to start the drive, and he fires one incomplete.
Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
I'm darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Here's second and 10. Looking to throw, Jones. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Tough series for the passing game. Things just aren't clicking. Hoping they can come through on this play and get this series back on track with a completion for enough yardage for a first down.
The offense on third down, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 10. Back to throw, Jones. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown, Giants. Daniel Bellinger, 53 yards. And the Giants are able to extend their lead.
And you know, you and I praise tight ends in today's game a lot for being just like a bigger-bodied wide receiver. Boy, a play that long from that position, you just didn't used to see that as much.
No, you were really just counting on the tight end position to catch the football and get what they got on the catch. And now it's the run after the catch that makes them so dangerous. Hard to bring those big guys down when they get rolling.
Couldn't bring him down here. Got into the end zone.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Open man is the tight end, Noah Gray. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, give him 14.
A promising sign there from an offense that hasn't done a whole lot to this point. Nice job to locate the open receiver. And it's good yardage and a first down to open the drive.
Mahomes going to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Rice. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit. And another first down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender. And that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Throwing now is Mahomes. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Now a second and 10. And again, it's Mahomes. That ball caught. It's Rice. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Rashee Rice, 27 yards. And the Chiefs have cut it back within a score.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Harrison Butler, kickoff. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. In Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Ball on the 30 now. Here's second down and 8.
Click right.
A give up the middle to Singletary. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Now on third down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Looking to throw. Jones able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Giants first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert here on 3rd and 3. They'll look to throw now on first down. That one taken in by Neighbors. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Okay, here we go. Rita. Ladybug.
Back to throw. Jones, a throw right side caught by Neighbors. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Again, he'll drop to throw. His throw incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops and escape this drive.
On 2nd and 10, Jones, and his throw here is going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on 3rd down.
Here we go.
back to throw again. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Well, it hasn't been a banner first half for the defense trying to cover him today, but they'll take that one right there, helping force that incompletion.
And here's Gillen on now to punt as he gets this one away. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
And maybe that touchdown on the previous drive has re-energized this offense a little bit. They've been kind of sluggish until then, but they're showing signs of life here, and they get good yardage that time in a first down.
Final shot before the half from Mahomes. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we come upon halftime here with the visiting Giants out on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead, and they are set to receive this kick. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys are lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing 4-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
To throw once more on second and 10. Jones, and his throw is going to be incomplete.
This defense has passed its first two tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know there's probably another throw coming on third down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he is caught, and he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. Down to about the 45. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the 45 on second down, Jones.
And this throw incomplete. The defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
Looking to throw, Jones. That is caught by Johnson. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 20-yard line. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards.
What a drive this has been. Just chewing up the yardage. And here's one of their best plays yet as they finally get down into the...
We welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Two teams have met in Super Bowl 35 down in Tampa. The Ravens and Giants are underway.
And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
The Ravens take over first down here at their own 28-yard line.
Jackson looking to throw right away. And incomplete to open things up.
And that certainly could be a sign of things to come because they're blitzing to start this ball game, and it works for them there as they force the incomplete pass.
So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Now a first carry for Derrick Henry. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Crowd getting in it a bit already. Here's an early third and 10. Now it's Jackson. He's got his man. It's Andrews. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as he'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Jackson. That's for Bateman, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bobby Okereke. He may go. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
They're quite a turn of events. This is first and goal from the 3.
Here we go.
Singletary is into the end zone. Touchdown, Giants.
Well, that's how you take advantage of an early turnover. A sudden change situation, meaning ball's turned over. How's both sides going to handle it? One side handled it way better. They went right out on the field and put the ball in the end zone.
One play, that just added insult to injury.
Yeah, that just tells you on the defensive side, they didn't come out ready to go, still reeling from the fact that the ball got turned over.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Things a lot different than the last time they were on the field. Remember, they threw the interception, gave up the touchdown, and now trailing 7-0 and looking for a response. Give them a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Brandon, once that one broke down, there were only so many options left for him to take. Fortunately, only first down, so he smartly got the yardage he could get and didn't worry about trying to turn into a bigger play and end up taking a bigger loss. Here, they hope they can regroup and get something different going here on second down.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Now it's Jackson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Next receivers have spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
Throwing is Jackson. They set up the screen for Henry. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 47. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And now third down and 6 to go.
Brandon, how about that reaction there from a defensive end, able to recognize the screen pass trying to happen, broke off his pass rush, and then get back to tackle the running back. That's a very athletic and intelligent play. Reminds me of you working out and seeing that the treadmill's open and getting there before anyone else.
See, I know you're just patronizing me right now. Everybody knows at home that is nothing but a shot at me, and I'll take it, absorb it, and we'll move on.
10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on 3rd and 5, 3rd and 6, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another 1st and 10.
It's
from the gun, Jackson. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
From the gun, it's Jackson. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down. Back to the ground now, it's Henry. Bobby Okereke making that tackle.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
They'll come up 2nd and 7. Here's Jackson. He completes it to Henry. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up 1st and goal.
But it certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
Eluding the pressure right. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Raven football here as we begin quarter number 2. As they come up now, 2nd and goal. Henry, touchdown, Baltimore.
You think back to some of the great goal line bruisers of the past, the Earl Campbells, the John Riggins, the Marshawn Lynches. I think you can put Derrick Henry right in that group as he scores there with another patented Derrick Henry run.
Justin Tucker for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
Here we go, hey.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense... They just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now because they just...
And now off to the races, down the right side. And all the way in, touchdown, New York. Malik Nabers, 75 yards. And the Giants have taken the lead. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use than that. Man, one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
Oh, a good return up past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. The defense was dialed into the pass. They overlooked the draw play.
And how often do we talk about the oldies are still goodies? Because that draw play comes straight from Coach Paul Brown's playbook, going all the way back to the original Cleveland Browns.
Now Lamar changing the look. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They keep it with Henry on first down. And a good push there defensively as they stop him at the 48. Gain of just one.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier to shut it down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well.
They work now on second and nine. Jackson from the shotgun. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
The Ravens on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and nine. Here's Jackson to throw. This will go to Henry out wide. Room to maneuver at the 35. And down to the 28-yard line. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side. And he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. Jackson. Right back to Henry, and Henry's got it again. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Two yards to go, second down. And now the Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. From the 20, here's second and two. Again, Jackson. Flushed out right. Fights off the defender. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
Facing second and short, that gives you a chance to go for a bigger play through the air. But I think he said to himself, why don't I just handle this one? Got all the yards he needed and then some, and made that snap a huge success.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Now Jackson taps this forward, jet sweep.
Oh, that is well read defensively. A great job of setting the edge, and that little touch pass is going to turn into a loss.
It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal.
In motion, Aguilar. They'll get it forward to him on the touch pass.
And he will score. Touchdown, Baltimore. Nelson Aguilar. A 7-yard touchdown grab.
And the Ravens are within an extra point of tying up this ball game.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away.
And he returns this to the 22.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one. Any questions of how they'd approach this drive were answered right there. They come out throwing, and they get a nice pickup here toward the end of the first half.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Timberland, Timberland, Timberland.
Now Jones. And that one drops down, incomplete.
Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Good defensive call right there because they had someone shadowing him along his entire route. And he was right there ready to provide a hit that prevents him from making another catch to his big start.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Dom Capers, Dom Capers, Dom Capers.
Throwing, Jones. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Trenton Simpson.
And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Now, easy to second guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
A first down carry for Henry. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, how about the big guy there showing some agility? He just flowed from his D-tackle position in order to make that play.
Second and 9.
A toss left, Henry.
And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line.
Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half.
from the 34 now. Here's first and 10. Tenth carry now for Derrick Henry. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Second down and a yard. Jackson. That's caught. It's Flowers. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
It's all pretty simple sometimes, isn't it? Go where the defenders are not, and he does exactly that. Makes a nice catch to move the chains. Defense got to find a better way of accounting for the shorter routes that are being run against them.
To throw is Jackson. Now he's got it. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Rashad Bateman on a touchdown throw from Lamar Jackson. And the Ravens have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Tucker with the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Jones now. A final shot before break. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Giants set to get the football, and they trail here as we get back underway in the second half. And he's going to be stopped cold. Good coverage there by the kick team to bring that return to an abrupt halt. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? They'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
First down, they stick with Singletary. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last 2 snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I'd keep going back to him.
Throw left side, taken in by Slayton. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
Apple.
Off play action. Jones. And this one's incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
South salad.
Back to throw. Jones. That's caught left side by Neighbors. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a gain of 34.
We know play callers can be very creative in this game today, but sometimes when they've got receivers with speed like this, they don't need to design incredibly complex calls. Sometimes it's just get the ball in his hands and let him do his thing. In a sense, less can become more, and it was right there.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5.
Great.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And now look at him go. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
Well, the defense obviously could not have drawn up a better start to the second half. They're holding on to that slim lead, just looking for a stop. Not only do they get the stop, Charles, they get the pick six.
Another example that life comes at you fast, doesn't it? One play ago, they're defending a slim lead coming out of the break. Now they're one more stop away from thinking about a possible put-away drive.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And no thought of bringing this one out. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll begin the drive at the 30. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
Bama.
And not the first time that they're coming back out off of a turnover, but the last one really hurt, Charles, with that pick six.
And it feels like the whole team's infected right now, doesn't it? It's not just been one person. It's kind of been a group effort where the mistakes have happened. Can they put that aside, kind of start over, and put together a nice drive?
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Looking to throw. Jones. And that's caught inside the 35. And finally, he's taken down at the 18.
Gold cutter. Great.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And that is caught. He's got it for a Giant touchdown. Darius Slayton, an 18-yard touchdown.
And the Giants are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. Gano for the extra point. He's got it, and they're back
within a touchdown at 28-21. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. 62 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
From the 29, here's second and four.
Again, it's Henry. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. So both teams trade touchdowns in the third as we're through three quarters of play. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back now here in East Rutherford. It's the Ravens in control of the football. They've also got the lead as we get set for the fourth.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
They'll try and choose some clock with Henry. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Oh, design run for their wideout.
And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47.
19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success. How about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 47. Running from the gun with Henry. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line.
So with your team leading in the fourth quarter, you know you've got to run the football. They know you've got to run the football. Sometimes that means there's nowhere to run the football.
Yeah. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Oh. And the busy night for Henry continues.
On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with, and throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.